Well, now to a special report into the mental health crisis facing our farmers. Alex went back to the land for this special investigation. Alex, it's a big problem.
It is, Carl. It's my happy place, but not such a happy story, unfortunately. We've known for many years that farmers are doing it tough. But sadly, a new report released today paints an increasingly devastating picture. In recent years, nearly half of all Aussie farmers have felt depressed. Almost two-thirds experienced anxiety, and farmers are twice as likely to take their own life compared to the rest of the population. But one man in Queensland is single-handedly helping turn those stats around, dedicating countless hours a week to counselling fellow farmers, all while running a dairy farm of his own.
Driving out to Lower Mount Walker, an hour west of Brisbane, the grass is a vibrant shade of green.
G'day, Ross.
How you going?
How are you?
Pretty good.
Good to see you.
Real good.
Dairy farmer Ross Blanche is 67, and most of those years have been spent right here, on this farm. He's seen it all. Years of terrible drought, devastating floods, and financial heartache.
Come on, come on.
It's just day in, day out. You're concerned about your stock because the feed is diminishing. It's very expensive and you just can't see the end of it. It just cripples you day after day after day.
But instead of bottling it all up, Ross is using his experience for good. 30 or so years ago, he felt a calling to help others. So, he joined the volunteer team at Lifeline.
How are they treating you, Barry?
This year alone, he's taken over 700 crisis calls, many to fellow farmers.
The fear of failure on farms is a big issue when it comes to mental health, and it can drive people over the edge. And yeah, unfortunately, farmers over generations have had this perception that you get on and tough it out. If you can get away with it, don't talk. But reaching out is a strength, not a weakness.
According to a new report, close to a third of Aussie farmers have reported a decline in their mental health over the past few years.
Have you stopped people taking their own lives over the years?
Yeah, I've definitely saved a few in my day. I know that people have been pretty close, like, I don't know how many, but there'll be a few dozen. Could be more.
One person who reached out and turned their life around is Rob McRae. When his wife passed away, Rob became a single parent to five young children and was left to run the family cattle farm on his own. We should not look back
on the things that make us sorry. Out here on the farms, you're remote from most people, it's very quiet. I just lost my best mate, and you know, the person that's always been my support and the one that's always sort of, you could bounce everything off, and then all of a sudden that was gone. And he was that guy that just came in and understands the way that farmers have to live their life and the risks we take all the time, just, you know, relying on the weather and things like that.
I got the colour, eh? Yeah,
with calls for help on the rise, Ross is working with Norco to train more farmers to offer crisis support. Farmers like young mum Stephanie van der Westen, who found herself in a very dark place during the recent drought.
We were fencing the dam off. I was a week away from having a child, waist deep in water, driving in posts just to prevent cows from drowning.
You're an inspiration, Award.
There is no doubt Ross is a hero.
Yeah, so.
A man who is changing and saving lives.
Ross is so understanding and approachable that it made so much difference. And he's just one of those people that can just brighten up your day, and he's a good listener.
It's made me a lot more confident person, and knowing that I can do this and help people. I just do the best I can. If you do your best, that's it.
Ross, you're a legend.
Brilliant.
I love him. I just do.